Hello, it's G again. My hair is purple. Update. Actually, this is a vlog rant, sort of, about Lujan filing a lawsuit against SM Entertainment. Ooh, sorry about the whole weird, awkward. I'm trying to. Okay, anyways, so I know people are. I'm not really mad or upset about Lujan and this whole. Nullifying his contract. We don't know that he's actually nullifying, because that can't be released or talked about in reality. So some of this stuff can be just over exaggerated. But even if it is, I'm not upset. Because to be honest, a lot of fans are just taking this too personal, as if SM's doing it on purpose and stuff like that to make their artists sleep. But in reality, it's nothing like that. Because, okay, take this from perspective of a big company. Sure, the fans can get mad, like, oh, well, he wants to leave. Like, Chris and Jessica also are including this, that Chris wanted to do more. He wanted to do acting. You know, he wanted to have. He wanted more to be more, not, it's not that he was being treated badly, it was more like he wanted to be able to do more. Hanjin too, he wanted to be able to do more. He wanted to act, have solo songs, have more than just that part of the song, do things that really expressed who he was. So Chris wanted to do that as well. Jessica wanted to do something that she would express her as an artist, which would be her, her fashion line, Blanc, whatever. And you know, it's not saying that that's a bad thing that they want to express themselves, but it's more like you can't be expected, like, okay, let me put this in words. You can't expect SM to give them everything they want. You can be like, oh, well, YG lets G-Dragon have a solo. He lets Taeyang have a solo. He lets CL have a solo. But if you think about this, how often do Big Bang and 21 have their comebacks? Isn't it already been a year or two or something since Big Bang's comeback? You can't expect them to have a comeback because YG lets them do what they want. It's not even saying that that's a bad thing, but from a company's perspective, that's not making them money, because. Sure, oh, well, they get free time. The rest of the members get free time whenever they're not having their. Whenever G-Dragon and CL. Whenever G-Dragon and Taeyang are having their solos, where it's like, well, oh, well, all the rest of the members get to do what they want. You know, they get to have free time. But it's like. I'm not even being a hater, but what G-Dragon does is setting back for their comeback. And if you notice, most of the time, G-Dragon and CL are not in Korea. Most of the time, they're at fashion shows in London, you know, in Paris. So you can't expect them to be having frequent comebacks if they're out doing what they want. You know, they like fashion. I even think they have their own little fashion lines themselves. But because they're having to take care of that stuff, and they're taking care of their solos, and they're out there doing what they want to do as an artist, the rest of the group is getting held back, as you see. So it's not like YG's a better company, you know? SM, they're taking this that they still want to make money, you know? So you can't expect them to be okay with Jessica taking time away to do her fashion line. Because idols, they're promoting for almost 8 months out of the whole year. Yes, that's actually a really lot of time. Just because their stages only last 4 weeks doesn't mean they're not out there promoting still. They're still out there going on shows. They're getting interviewed. They're in magazines. They're doing fan meets. They're going all across Korea doing stuff. So, you can't. In SM2 with Girls' Generation XO, they're not even promoting just in Korea. They're promoting in China and Japan. And Taiwan and all that. So you can't expects them to be like, oh yeah, we'll put everything off for you, Jessica, so you can go promote your fashion line. And Jessica not only wanted to do her fashion line, she also wanted to go to school on top of that. And going to school is not as easy as it sounds. It will take a lot of time. She'll be tired. She's going to be tired from having to work on her clothing line. She's going to be tired from having to work, go to school. And like, how are you supposed to go to school, do a fashion line, and be able to promote fully and wholeheartedly without being so tired all the time with SNSD? That doesn't make sense. She would be too tired to give her whole, give it her all in her performances with SNSD. So of course it's like, it was the right thing to do for SM to kick her out of SNSD. They let her go. Of course they should have talked to her about it, but still she was still holding on to the fact that she thought she could do it all, when in reality you can't do it all. You can't have it all your way. Chris, I love EXO and I love Sonashi. Okay, I like Sonashi, I don't love them. But, you know, it's not like, oh, I have a thing against them. With EXO, it's like, Chris could do so much more. He wanted to act, he wanted to sing, he wanted to be more than just the Chinese rapper. But that was not possible either. If EXO has a comeback basically every year. So if for promotions that last, like, usually 8 months, but not only are they going to be promoting together as EXO in Korea for their songs, of course they're going to be moving, the Chinese members are going to go separately and go promote in China. So that takes even longer. So basically they're going to be promoting basically that full year, maybe a month off, and then they're going to have to start preparing for their next album. So where does acting and having his solo fit into there? It wouldn't be possible. And so, of course, he would have to leave the company to be able to do all that. SM can't give their artists everything. Luhan, he probably wants to be just more than just the vocalist and face of EXO. He wants to be able to do more as an artist. And you can't blame them for wanting to do more, you know? But you can't blame SM either, saying, oh, SM should burn, SM is so bad, everybody should just leave SM. That SM's doing this responsibly. That it's not all about the artists, to be honest. You can't say, oh, well, they should just focus on all their artists. But it's like, what about the staff? SM has probably 1,000 staffs working with them for SM China and SM Korea. So what about all of them? If they just took care of the artists, they're going to be losing money, and they're going to have to get rid of, like, staffs would lose their job. SM needs to make money too, you know? So you can't put all the blame on SM, saying that they should do better, but SM's doing all they can. If the artists if the artists feel like they're being treated unfairly, they should also know that it's okay for them to leave, you know? People shouldn't make such a big deal and saying, like, acting like it's a life or death. The artists are moving on to do something better, that they, you know, they'll move on to companies that they feel will treat them better and be able to give them what they want. If SM gave everyone their own solo or acting, where would any of the music come in? No one would be having comebacks because everybody would be too busy. And why would SM waste money and put it into something like acting if they're not even sure that it will succeed? And you can't be like, oh, well, they're talented, they could do anything. What about when last year when SM put Sonashi De into acting? That didn't do as great as it wanted to, so of course they're going to be like, oh, well, if Sonashi De, one of our biggest artists, couldn't make it that great, why should we continue to fund something like this? We should wait till they're more ready. When they put Super Junior, Donghae and Siwon into acting in the Taiwanese drama Skit Beat, that didn't do well either. So if their top two their top two groups that make the money, if they're not doing good in this stuff, how are they going to be sure that, oh, well, how are they going to be like, oh, well, I think Luhan and Chris will do good, so we should go put them into something. Why should they fund something that they're not sure will succeed? More, they could be losing money. So they're still a company. They're not just, you know, like, you can't expect them to give everything as to the artists. Like, they have to make money too. And of course, it's like, it's not all about the money, but in retrospect, it really is. Because if SM does not have money, because for those people boycotting, that's really stupid. And that's actually really selfish. If SM doesn't have money, then not only is it the CEO of SM going to be out of a job, the stocks are dropping, people are pulling out, they're losing money right now. And if people start boycotting and not watching their videos on YouTube, which makes some money too, if y'all didn't know, then of course, like, you're not just affecting the CEO's life, you're affecting the lives of everyone that works in SM. The stylists, the music producers, the people who make the music videos, the cameramen, the actors too, because if SM loses money, that's going to come out of their paychecks. They're going to have to, the people that go that live from paycheck to paycheck will have to get it taken down more just because some fans decided, oh, well, SM doesn't deserve to make this money, so I'm just going to not watch anything or buy anything from them anymore. All because one member left the group. And if a member decides to leave a group, it's nobody's fault. Like, it's not SM's fault, it's not the artist's fault. So fans should keep this in mind whenever a member leaves the group. It's not the end of the world. Sunny Hill, just like, they lost a member, but they're still able to succeed. Just because somebody leaves the group doesn't mean that the group's gonna fail. Super Junior, they've lost like 4 members. UKISS has lost like 4 members, but they're still successful, you know? So just because somebody leaves a group doesn't mean that they're gonna fail. You shouldn't assume that they're gonna fail or hope that the group fails just because that one member left. Like, that's really selfish for fans to do that. And to be honest, you're not a fan if you stop supporting them just because one person left. Sure, you can like not, you don't, to be a fan, you don't even have to like every song they come out with, but to wish them bad just because somebody left, or wish their company bad because one member left because of one person, you're gonna let that affect so many more and you don't even realize it. Replying to stuff, sorry. Also, international fans need to be more aware of that. Just because, I know people will be like, well, Sunny Hill's not even popular. Just because Sunny Hill isn't popular internationally, or a group isn't popular internationally, doesn't mean that they're not popular in Korea. Us international fans, to be quite honest, don't really even affect most of the stuff for our artists. The Korean fans, they're what affects it, because they're the ones that are able to vote and go personally purchase all this that really makes it affect the charts and all that. We can pretend that all we want that we have a big effect on it, but if the Korean fans also play an even bigger part. And to say that just because somebody's not popular internationally, that they're not popular, that's really stupid. Like, that's like saying Hugok or 2BIC aren't popular just because us international fans don't favor them, you know? Just because we haven't heard of the artist does not mean they're not popular. In Korea, there's so much more. NEL, they're not popular here internationally, but there's so many fans of NEL in Korea. There's so many more groups than just K-pop that we get. What am I saying? There's so many fans of K-pop. There's so many more genres and styles of Korean music. It's not just K-pop. There's K-indie, there's K-rock, there's K-hip-hop. And I'm just saying K because K-Central Korean. So it's like, they're doing hip-hop, they're doing indie, they're doing all sorts of things. It's not just what we're getting. It's not just EXO or SNSD, Bangtan. You know, it's not just DBSK or JYJ, Daegook Nama. It's not just any of those. There's so much more that it's not even that idols, like, you can't pretend that idols rule the Korea, because idols are just, you know, they're just there. It's like saying, oh, well, Justin Bieber is everywhere and One Direction are everywhere. Everything revolves about Justin Bieber and One Direction here in the U.S. And if you think about it, it's like, no, that's not even true, you know? It's the same thing that just because we have that kind of music here doesn't mean that everybody likes it and it's popular. And this is kind of rambling. But yeah, those were just my thoughts that it's not... Let me just recap that. SM, it's not their fault. They're not a... it's not the artist's fault. SM can't give everybody what they want because that... Their company, they gotta look up to not just one person's need. They're looking after the whole company. There's people behind the cameras that we don't even see that they have to look after them too. It's not just all about the artists, and there's so much more than just K-pop. And that one idol group or one idol member, that just because you don't like it doesn't mean you have to take it out on the whole company. You know? Like saying, oh, Suman is so bad, when he wasn't even the one who owns the company. He was, by the way, rest in peace, his wife. She passed away from cancer, if you did not know. That it was actually Youngmin who is now in charge of SM. But so people were trending when Chris left, oh, well, he needs to die and he needs to, like, get kicked out. And it's like, are y'all really serious? Y'all want one man to lose his job because a member decided to leave for his own good so he could better himself? You know? And just because one person, but just because you don't like one person, you're mad about one person leaving doesn't mean you have to, like, take out all your hate on another person, you know? I don't know if that makes sense, but that's just my thoughts for this all. And it's currently 11:58 p.m. and I'm very shiny. Can you see that? My hair is purple. So this is, yes. In other news, we're gonna have try to get one of our friends who's also likes K-pop, and she also likes to sing, and I've actually collabed with her because she's my friend. So we're gonna try to get her to help us do some more K-pop reactions. So if you want to send in your K-pop cover, or it doesn't even have to be K-pop cover, any cover you want, even your own original music, if you'd like, if you want us to review it, just go ahead and send it in into the request form that's in the description, and we'll review it in our next video. So videos will hopefully be up by next Tuesday or Monday. Hopefully Monday, but maybe next Tuesday. And yes. So this is, because I know people will probably be like, oh, well, you don't understand anything. It's like, come on. You gotta think about it, just not take all this so personally. You know? Oops, whatever. So yes, I'm gonna stop because this is already like 19 minutes long and we ain't about that life, right? So, bye!